أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمد هو ونصلي على رسول الكريم nowadays we are discussing history of زكريا عليه السلام last time we had discussed we have covered two lectures and today we are inshallah starting with the third one we are going to discuss from we are starting with ayat number 38 of surah 3 the background of this ayat is that hazrat zakaria alaihi salam whenever he goes to hazrat maryam alaihi salam in her chamber which quran refers to as mihrab there he finds fruits for her and he is asking her that from where this fruit comes she then tells that it is from our lord from my lord from allah subhanahu wa taala this is a very simple statement though but it has lost a lot of hikmat for parents for guardians for those who have the custody of children whether legal custody or otherwise hazrat zakaria alaihi salam was given the kafala of Hazrat Maryam and there is also an indication that how a good child behaves how with the parents or with the guardian Hazrat Zakaria alaihi salam without creating any discord or any ill feeling he is asking very lovingly from Maryam alaihi salam although she is living in the masjid and in the center of the masjid that is mihrab she is well protected she is trustworthy she is an excellent child in spite of that it is the duty of the parents and the guardians to keep an eye on the children nowadays it is becoming difficult and more difficult to keep an eye on the children but besides that people are ignoring them people are not keeping the parents are not performing their duties for example it's very difficult today to see what the children are watching on the television on the telephone on the computer but when Hazrat Zakaria alaihi salam is asking her just for a very simple thing which is very obvious she's in a very well protected environment but still he's asking her that from where these fruits are coming so that he it shows that he was a good guardian and keeping eye on everything and she also as a good child she is saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends these fruits we will discuss this in more in detail inshallah when we discuss Hazrat Maryam alaihi salam's case her history it is in that background that that this ayat tells us that at that answer which Maryam alayhi salam gave that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends me the fruits now Zakaria alayhi salam is overwhelmed and he immediately stands up he goes to the musalla and he prays to God and he is requesting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayat that gave me zuriyatan tayyibatan a pious child a pious progeny good progeny here he is overwhelmed by the reply of the child and it is in that background that here he is using the word zuriyatan tayyibatan but at other places we will find that where he is requesting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give him waris he is using the word wali give me a wali because I am afraid of the mawali people who will come after me so there he is using the word wali and at other places the different words are used but Allah subhanahu wa taala when he is talking to him or when the malaika are sent to give him the good news they are using the word ghulam which means boy So every ayat has its own context. Here, Hazrat Zakariya alayhi salam is overwhelmed by the pious conduct of Maryam alayhi salam, and he is requesting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he may be given a child who is pious. And then in this ayat, he is using the word innaka sami'ud du'a. You listen and accept the du'a. And I had pointed out that at other places, Hazrat Zakariya alayhi salam is using different words. What is the lesson? The lesson is that du'a is not a prescribed, printed, or just limited frame in which we have to make a du'a. Some people think that if you read such and such ayat, or you recite such and such kalma, then that is the du'a and it will be accepted. It's not like that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala listens in every language. Even if there's no language, there are many people who can't use their tongue. But Allah listens to them. Allah says, Yahulu bainal mar'i wa kalbihi. Allah exists before even the thought occurs in the human mind or in any mind. So here, Zakariya alayhi salam is saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala listens to every dua. Whether you make a dua, you make a dawa, you make a nada. Quran has used in the statement, in the story of Zakariya alayhi salam, different words. Not just one word. Dua, dawa, nada. Call. You can talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in any manner. Whatever is your emotional state, but khufiyan, but tamam, silently and with all humility. If you make a dua, you just even think of it, even before thinking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the Prophet, peace be upon him, that I know, why are you looking upwards? You want the change of Qibla. I have done it. Prophet had not yet asked. This is the connection. There's no need of any prescription. This we have made it that if you recite this surah 3 times or 100 times, or you recite the kalma 100 times or the zikr 1,000 times, there's no such condition. Quran doesn't prescribe any such condition. No prescribed formula. Now, malaika are responding. They are bringing a bashara. For nadathu, malaika are calling him. Now, this is another ayah. We were here at ayat number 38. He has made a dua. And now we are coming to, and first I had given the background from 35, 36, and now in 39. The malaika are calling Hazrat Zakariya alayhi salam. Now this ayah tells that he was standing on the musalla, in the mihrab. Mihrab is from Hebrew, and its root is harab. It means to fight. Mihrab is the chamber where, according to Jewish belief and the explanations given there, they call it mihrab. It is the place of war, harb. War with what? War with nafs. They thought that the rabbi, the leader, Hazrat Zakariya alayhi salam, he was the leader, he was the imam of the Jews at that time. And the chamber, this mihrab, was considered to be the most sacred place, the central place where the rabbi would sit, where the imam would sit, and he would do tazkiyah enough, he would do critical thinking, he would think into the Torah and the scripture, study, and there are other explanations. We'll go slowly into those. And they are telling him that, of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you a basharat with Yahya. You will get a son. Yahya. If from Hayya, it has so many meanings. But generally, it is translated as the pious boy, pious son, that here it means one who has haya, who is living. And he will be tasting the word of God. This is the job description of a prophet, that the prophet comes to attest the message of God, bikalimatillah, the word of God. But here today, what we are doing, we are not attesting the word of God. We are attesting what other people have translated, and we are fighting on that. Because since so and so had translated it, that is sufficient for me, and I'll fight on that. That here, not only in this ayah, but at many other places also, one of the most important job descriptions of the prophet and also the purpose of sending the scripture, like Quran, is to attest the message, the kalma, which has already been sent. Like Quran attests, corrects the musaddiqan. It includes the meaning, not only attestation as it is, like a notary. Attestation here means attestation with correction, so that it corresponds, it tallies with the original. So musaddiqan means he will be attesting, he will be testifying, he will be correcting the kalma which has been corrupted so far. And then it is telling so many other qualities of Yahya alayhi salam. The prophet, the angels are telling in advance that he will be honorable. He will be abstaining. He will be controlling himself. He will be a person who can control his nafs, who can abstain from evil. Husura. He will be abstaining. What we do in Psalm, in Ramzan, or in fasting, that we abstain, we control ourselves, and he will be a prophet. Another very important lesson, hikmat, in making a dua. Now, in this ayat, although malaika have given the basharat, but in response, again in continuity, Hazrat Zakariya alayhi salam is not asking them to give me such and such thing, not from malaika. And he is not even asking them that you make this request to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we do. We ask others, make a dua for me. Although it's not a sin, but we all usually ask others, make a dua for me, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this thing. Here, malaika are talking to Zakariya alayhi salam, and in response, in reply, he's not asking them. He's talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Continuously, you will find that Zakariya alayhi salam, whenever malaika are interacting with him, Zakariya alayhi salam talks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He demands Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Demands from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a great lesson that he is asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In contrast, we find in Quran that the people of Musa alayhi salam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had asked them to slaughter a cow, all the time they were asking Musa alayhi salam, ask your Lord, ask your Rabb to tell us this thing. Ask your Lord to tell us what we should do. But here Zakariya alayhi salam is talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself. And then he's saying, how can I have a ghulam? How can I have a boy? How can I have a son? Ghulam means a boy, young, adolescent. How can I have a boy? And he is telling them that I am so old, extremely finished. And my wife is also akram. She is also born barren. Then how can I have this? At another place also we'll find this statement. Here he is telling the malaika, asking them, how can I have? And they are replying in third person. They are telling him that yes, it will be done like that. It is as it will be done, and Allah will do this. The malaika are clarifying that Allah will do this, and Allah, whatever he desires, whatever he intends, he does it. He can do that. They are clarifying this. And then in another ayah, there is a different context. We'll discuss it there. That what he say, what Zakaria alayhi salam is saying, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is responding. At this, in ayat 41, is continuing. Zakaria alayhi salam is again talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kala Rabb. He's asking his Lord, talking to Lord, and asking him to give me the instruction. Ayah means sign, proof. It has many meanings. It has verse, and ayat also means indication and instruction. He's asking him. Now it's a great phenomenon is going to happen, which is not a usual, a routine phenomenon. Something different is going to happen, that I am going to have a son in this situation. Then give me some instructions. What should I do? How should I behave? What will happen? What should I do? Give me ayat, instruction. And then the instruction is given that you should not talk to people straight, direct. Don't talk about this directly for 3 days. In another ayat, word Sabiya has been used, that don't talk direct to the people on this issue. Don't tell them till it happens. Keep quiet. And usually, why 3 days? Here, 3 days are mentioned. In another ayat, 3 nights are mentioned. So it means 3 days and 3 nights. Don't speak to people directly, and don't speak about this issue. Don't speak directly on this matter, in this matter, and keep quiet. And usually it is said that if something happens, there is a rumor, for example, or anything which is spreading, or any whisper, usually in 3 days it dies down. This is psychology. The social psychology tells that if there is something, and if you can divert the attention in public administration also, in public matters also, some event has taken place, handle it at least for 3 days and divert the attention. Better keep quiet. It's not always necessary to speak about every event and comment upon every event. Wait for some time. It will die down. So he is being asked not to speak directly on the in the matter. Keep quiet for at least 3 days. 3 days and nights. When we say ayam, and we at other place layal, it is included. And in the meantime, you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Keep in contact with Him. Continue your exercise in the mihrab. Continue your salat. Continue your critical thinking. Continue reading Torah. Continue your contact with God. So evening and morning, every time. Now, in Surah Maryam, in Ayat 7, last time also I had shown this ayat. Here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Zakaria alayhi salam, himself. First, the malaika have come, and he has raised the question. And here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking, or talking to him. Malaika had used the word nada. I'm not going into all those details. And here, Zakaria. But I may explain, I may invite your attention to this word. In Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when first he's talking to Adam alayhi salam, he's not talking directly. Kal. He spoke with him. But after some time, when in the meantime, Hazrat Adam alayhi salam had committed a mistake that showed that he had gone slightly or to some extent away in thinking, away. And at that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using the word nada, he called him, oh, where is your attention? Where are you? I had asked you, don't do this. Don't go near this wild growth. I had given you the fruits and you are still forgotten it. Now here is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is directly asking Zakaria, Zakaria, inviting his attention. Yes, I have myself given you the basharat. Nubashiruka was sufficient, but inna, emphasizing, yes, I have myself sent you this basharat. Begulamin, for the boy. He had asked, you remember last time we had discussed, he had asked for wali and he had asked for waris. Lamakum be duaika rabbi shakiya. We had discussed that, and then he says that you are the warisin, khairul warisin, give me a waris. Wali, give me wali. Who should be the waris? My waris and waris of the Al Yaqub. That here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in response says, not only wali, not only waris, but I'll give you your own boy, your own son, ghulam. And his name will be Yahya. He will be with Haya. And I have not given this name. The who is in fact the epitome of Haya, such a person. And I'll make him maybe other ayat if he connect with this. So he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving him not only wali, but a waris, and not only waris, but his own son. And he is making him Nabi. In acceptance of Zakariya's prayer, God made Yahya to continue his message, musaddiqan bikalmati, that he will continue his message, which had been corrupted and lost by the Israelites. They are admitting themselves. It is written in the Torah, in the it is written in the New Testament, Luke 1:16. This is New Testament, where it says, and many of the children of Israel shall turn to the Lord their God. Yahya alayhi salam will turn many people to God who have left God, who have gone away from God. Now, in this ayat, we have seen that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling that his name will be Yahya. Allah has named him. But when he's born, then the family, when they want to name him, then as usual, you have seen in your families also that people have different proposals. Whether people are concerned or not, but people will advise you that keep his name like this or name him like this. When Yahya was to be named, neighbors, well-wishers, relatives assumed that he was to be named after his father. Usually they give the name of a family. They assume that Yahya will be given the name in the line of the family. For example, father, grandfather's name, great-grandfather's name. But his mother, Elizabeth, Zakaria's wife, she is telling them, she insisted that his name was to be Yahya, because Zakaria had told her that his name has to be Yahya. But relations, sisters, brothers, elders, neighbors, they are saying, no, the name should be in the family. Usually it happens. And at that, Zakaria alayhi salam closes the discussion, not only by saying, but he writes the name, he wrote his name on the table. His name is Yahya, because Allah had told him. Now this statement of Quran is also corroborated by the statements in the Bible that he was named as Yahya, and although there were different proposals. You have seen in the case of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam, when there is close contact, connectivity with God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not stopping, not discouraging critical thinking or thinking or asking. When people are not asking the questions, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself initiates, ask a question. He is telling the Prophet, yes, Alunuk, they are asking you, reply. And reply like this. Like Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he was discussing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how you give life, how you give death, how it will happen, how this can happen, just to satisfy his own thinking, mind. And he tells that, and Allah accepts it. Allah discusses. Allah wants engagement with him. Then he is telling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also, How can I have a gulam? How can I have a boy? First he had told the malaika, that now even Allah has told him. But his situation was such, he was completely old, and his wife was completely barren. In that situation, he wants to satisfy his heart. Again asking Allah, how can I have a gulam? How can I have a boy? And he's telling him that she is born barren and I'm old. How can I have? Kala kazalika. Again, he is being satisfied. Again, he is being informed. He is not being scolded. If a child asks question second time or third time, or even our father, mother who are old, our grandparents, they ask a question and they ask questions many times. But when they repeat the question, we get angry. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not getting angry. That my malaika told you, they explained to you, you are my prophet, you are my you are close to me, and still you are asking me again and again. But no, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is again satisfying him that it will happen. It will happen like that, yes. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells him that it is easy for me. It will be done. It is he who does it. This thing is very easy for me. I had created you. Now here, this statement, وَقَدْ خَلَقْتُكَ مِنْ قَبْلُ وَلَمْ تَكُ شَيْئًا. You are nothing when I created you. It refers to two things. One is the general evolution, that man was nothing, not even in Shah. But when it came in Shah, then it came to be created as Shay. So it is referring to the evolution, and at the same time, it has also a slight connotation that maybe Zakariya alayhi salam was also born in special circumstances, as Yahya is being born, as Isa alayhi salam was born, as Adam was born. Similarly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling him that you were nothing, I created you. And again, he is asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly, give me an instruction. What should I do? And here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is clarifying the instruction to a more extent. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells him that your instruction is that you don't speak to the people 3 nights, which means 3 days and 3 nights. Saviya, directly, keep quiet. Except saying something indirectly, don't talk about this so that people don't ask you any questions and you don't tell them about this. These are the two places where Layal and Ayam have been used, which means both the days and the nights. And this is the meaning of the ayat, which I said, instruction also. In Surah 24, Ayat 1, and Surah 3, Ayat 13, as it has been translated. Also, it has been translated as teachings, instructions, and lesson. So he's asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give me instructions, what should I do? And Luke tells us, the New Testament tells us, that after receiving good tidings of a son, Yahya alayhi salam, of Yahya alayhi salam, when Zakariya went out to the waiting people attending worship in the temple's outer courts, outside the masjid, people were waiting for him. He, as usual, that from the mihrab, he would come out and deliver a lecture. He did not speak the customary blessings, and he just told them indirectly that you continue your zikr day and night. And Quran tells about this in Surah 19, Ayat 11. The same thing, that when he comes out of mihrab, and he did not talk to the people. he just gave them instructions and then he proceeded further. Now there are certain other ayat of Quran about this matter, and they have a background which goes back to the mother of Hazrat Maryam, and then certain other things, and that will take us into another topic. Therefore, I stop here, and then we can take it up, inshallah, next time. Subhan Rabbika Rabbil Izzat Amma Yasifun Wa Salamun Alal Mursaleen Wa Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم أهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك اللهم لنا فيمن سقيت وقنا واصلح عنا شر ما قضيت فإنك يا ربنا تقضي بالحق ولا يقضى عليك. اللهم ادخلنا في رحمتك في عبادك الصالحين. اللهم اخرجنا من ظلمات الجهل والوهم إلى نور العلم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما. اللهم اجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون احسنه. اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك وبطاعتك عن معصيتك وفضلك عن من سواك. اللهم فضلك ورحمتك على كلمه الحق والدين. اللهم انصر الاسلام وعز المسلمين يا اكرم الاكرمين. او الله spread your mercy upon us, shower us with your blessings, increase our knowledge, grant us forgiveness and reward us with the company of the prophets in the firdaws al-a'la. او الله forgive our parents and all our friends and relatives who have passed away. O Allah, grant them your mercy. Make their graves garden from heaven and grant them the Firdaws al-A'la. O Allah, remedy our son Ma'raj and our daughter Aishawani and all our friends and relatives who are sick. O Allah, grant them full and speed recovery. O Allah, there is no cure but yours. O Allah, grant them a cure that leaves no ailment or injury. O Allah, guide our children, protect them and make them righteous. O Allah, we seek from you all of the good, whether we know it or we don't. And we seek your refuge from all evil, whether we know it or we don't. O Allah, we ask with every name you have elected for yourself, that none of us leave this gathering, but his pains have been relieved, his worries have been removed, his debts have been paid, his weaknesses have been concealed, his sins have been forgiven, and his needs have been fulfilled. سبحان الله وبحمده عدد خلقه ورضا نفسه وزنة عرشه ومداد كلماته. سبحان الله وبحمده عدد خلقه ورضا نفسه وزنة عرشه ومداد كلماته. سبحان الله وبحمده عدد خلقه ورضا نفسه وزنة عرشه ومداد كلماته. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على خير المرسلين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم عليكم ورحمة